this is what the brother, a young man was telling me this morning. He says, 40 years, I was away from my home. I ran away. And I was alone in a room. And I had no advice. I had the wrong advice, but not from wise people. And whenever you need an advice, seek men and women of God. Don't go to the comadre system because it's going to give you the wrong advice. And don't go to people that you know they're going to tell you what you want to hear. Go with those brothers that come to the prayer meetings, that pray, that seek the Lord, men of wisdom. In the Bible, we hear this passage that says that the wise older woman advises the younger woman, teach her to be under the teaching discipline. No direction, no advice, no protection. This is something, wow, no protection. Out of discipline, out of the home, out of the covering that God has established for us, there's no protection against the darts of the adversary. Because authority and discipline, whether we like it or not, is a shield. It will protect us from the darts of the adversary. And it's like an umbrella over us. See, this young man had issues since he was probably 15 years old. He was probably complaining about the authority of his father since he was 15 years old or young. But nothing happened to him. No darts came because he was under the covering. When he moved out from his father's house to a faraway country, that's when he identified with the devil. You know, rebellious, identified with the devil. Undisciplined, identified with the devil. Famine, God's instrument. Abruna is a Latin word. And there's nothing to eat. And famines have happened in all continents, 5 continents. But when he had spent all, there arose a severe famine in that land, and he began to be in want. Famines through the years have been a worldwide situation. We learned that in Spain there was a famine on 1939 to 1945 where 200 people died of starvation. We see a famine, a bruna, in Africa, Ethiopia, and in all continents, even here in the deserts with the natives in the past. But listen, this is what Wikipedia describes. A scarcity of food, that's a famine. Crop failure, malnutrition, starvation, epidemics, and increased mortality. So the Bible says, a famine came to the land and he didn't know what to do. But Wikipedia is saying, no, this is what it is. Deprived, a scarcity of food. Crops, failure, malnutrition, starvation, epidemic, people getting sick, and increased mortality, people dying early. himself in this situation, far away from his house. Sin, disobedience, will always carry you to the lowest places. It will carry you to the lowest places. Here is a young man with a pig. Listen to the word, and you can avoid what this young man will do. Let me explain this to you. This young man was a Jewish boy, a good Jewish boy. He had a training of his father and a training of his mother, observing the Levitical law, the teachings of Moses, because he was a Jewish boy. And he was prohibited, I would say even a blasphemy, to be with pigs, touch pigs or eat pigs, pork, swines. This is why he's crying. Because he said, what am I doing here? This is contrary to the teachings of my father. This is contrary to the teachings of my mother. You know, when you go from under the love that God has provided for you, and you find yourselves in the gutter, what am I doing here? Why do I have to be here? This is not what my mom and my dad gave me. That was a choice, son. It carries so much for me. Now, look where I am. Then he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him to a field to feed swine. And he will greatly have filled his stomach with the pots that the swine ate. But the owner said, don't you dare touch that. You're starving, that's your problem. It is for my pigs. And you know the beautiful thing that it blesses me? The beautiful thing is this. I will arise. Turn to someone and tell someone, I will arise, brother. I will arise. But when he came to himself, he came to his senses. He said, how many of my father's hired servants have bread enough and to spare? And I perish with hunger. Even the workers on my father's farm are better off than me. Even the workers. I will arise and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. And the message for us this morning is that you don't have to be in that situation if you're going through something. The famine, the adversity, was the instrument of God to call on your attention.